We're now joined by Captain Victorino Acosta. He's the Philippine Coast Guard Station Commander in Batangas. Captain, good afternoon.
Yes, sir. Good afternoon, sir.
Now, the oil spill has reached the Verde Island Passage, something that we hoped would not happen, but it has now. Has the PCG in Batangas done an assessment of how much of the area has already been affected?
Yes, sir. According to the reports from the people, person on the ground, it already affected three barangays, sir.
Three barangays. And yes. How many people there are affected? How many residents are going to be affected by this?
Yes, sir. For now, we already coordinated with the SWD for the head zones. But for now, we're still assessing the damage that occurred.
Right. And just, Captain, just for the public to get a better grasp of how grave the situation could be, how big of a problem does this oil pose to the Verde Island Passage, and what effects could it possibly do there?
Yes, sir. Weeks ago, we already prepared our team, and we anticipated this situation right now. And according to our strike teams assigned in Verde Island, the situation is still under control as of this moment.
Okay. From what we reported, there are spill booms there in the area, but is that the only thing that the PCG can do for now?
Yes, sir. We already employed our counterparts from the private firms. They already rendered their oil spill equipment, like the oil spill booms, oil spill absorbent pads, and the like. Right now, we already put some artificial spill booms to strengthen the security or the oil spill that will occur further in the coastal areas of Isla Verde.
Okay, and if these efforts fail, what are the possible next areas the oil spill could affect there in Batangas?
So we already anticipated in the worst case scenario. Within 24 hours, we're monitoring the oil spill in Tingloy, in Mabini, in Bawan, and particularly here in Batangas City.
That's Tingloy, Mabini, and what's the other one, sir?
Bawan.
Bawan. And those areas are known fishing grounds, sir?
Right now, it's industrial. More on industrialized.
Okay. Now, we do want to know, sir, that the remote operated vessel the PCG was expecting in Japan, it arrived in Calapan Oriental, Mindoro. We're trying to get more information on that. But would you have any idea if it is already being used to locate and patch up the sunken tanker?
Right now, Batangas City has no jurisdiction over Oriental Mindoro.
Right, but no information has reached you yet about that ROV?
Yes, I don't have any information on their activities right now, sir.
Okay, how about the PCG talking to the U.S. Coast Guard and the Coast Guard also of Japan? Has any information reached you on possibly the U.S. Coast Guard helping extending its assistance in the oil spill that has reached Batangas? Any information on that?
Yes, the same. We don't have any information here in Batangas.
Okay. Captain Victorino Acosta of the Philippine Coast Guard in Batangas. Captain, thank you very much.
Thank you.